So today, Frost and Melissa, man, Eagles theme team, we got a brand new quarter, man. Eagles theme team is starting to get a little bit of love. Kevin Byer, Javon Curse. Now, I'll be honest, our D-line is definitely something that's probably the best thing the Eagles theme team has. But, hey, man, the only way it's going to get better is if you keep adding on to it. So they went ahead and gave us Javon Curse. He's the LTD now. The thing that sucks about these Ultimate Legends, man, they do not get anything for zero AP. So compared to like these promo cards that are getting like all these zero AP abilities, they're not getting anything. I did get Javon Curse. I bought him for, I think, about 800 and something. I don't know the exact price, but it was 800 some thousand. He's the LTD. He's definitely not worth that price. I'm going to be completely honest with you. I just got him because I got to look, man, I'm trying to get all the Eagles and I have nothing else to spend my coins on, so why not? I'm going to make it right back. It's not a big deal because they still left the Super Bowl House Rules event in the game. And you guys know, like, that thing is just spitting out coins. I don't know why it's still in the game. I'm not complaining. And as long as it's in the game, I'm going to keep making these coins. So I'm not complaining. But you see this new Javon Curse card. He looks pretty crazy, man. 96 speed, 98 finesse move. I mean, 98 blocks. He's going to be great in the run game. He's going to be great against the quarterback. And you guys know Javon Curse cards always play really good. I can show you guys, like I said, he doesn't get any, you know, X factor being the LTD. He doesn't get anything for zero, but he does get some he gets 2-1 AP slots, and it's the same abilities. You can pick between No Outsiders, Speedster, and Edge to the Elite. You can see I do have the No Outsiders on for 1 AP. And if you want to, you can change him to right end chem. And the reason why I have No Outsiders on is because I'm actually running a brand new defense. I started running it last night. Basically, I was running a 3-4 bear defense. Now, I haven't ran a defense anything. I haven't ran anything other than nickel normal since like Madden 20. So like, this is the first time I ever ran a different defense. But I was running a 3-4 bear last night. I was playing the house rules. I won like 3 Super Bowls in it. The reason why I want to run it is because I want to get to the quarterback, that's my mindset playing Madden. We're going to get to the quarterback in. I'll be honest, I was having some fun running the 3-4 bear, and you know, it definitely suits the Eagles defense a little better because all we have is defensive linemen. And this bear, how my D line kind of works, is Hassan Reddick. I got 1 AP No Outsiders on him also. Hassan Reddick and Javon Curse, those are my 2 edge rusher guys. It's 5 D linemen, so those are the 2 edge rushers. And then my interior guys is Minister, Jalen Carter, and Nolan Smith. Now, I didn't really want to put Nolan Smith on the interior because, I mean, he's a lightweight. But, I mean, I wanted to have the No Outsiders because, you know, but in a defense like this, you want to have all your run-stopping abilities. So you can just completely take the run game away. And then you can, you know, you can still put all your KOs and stuff back there. I'll basically show you all the abilities I'm running and stuff. On Byard, I got Pick Artist and Pick Artist for 0 and Deep End for 1. Now, I didn't max him out just because in this defense, I don't know if I'm really going to... I mean, honestly, I could still use his 0 AP mid zone in this defense. I'm not going to lie, I could. So tonight, I think my plan is I'm probably going to just get him maxed out. I don't know if the LCDs are still in packs. I think they are, so because the best thing to upgrade him is put the LCDs in there. The defensive lineman, because he's a lot cheaper than the actual cards. Try to snipe him for like under 500. I don't know if they're still in packs though. Somebody in the comments let me know if they're still in packs. If they are, then I think tonight what I'm going to try to do is just get Byard maxed out, get his 0 AP mid zone, because honestly it still will help me a lot in this defense. But as of right now, I just have Pick Artist on for 0 and Deep In. Then the Hassan Reddick's got the No Outsiders because he's one of my edge rushers. We got Channing Crowder with the 1 AP Lurker or Lurk Artist. Tim and Carmichael are still my guys for the box. Now, it sucks that I have to pay the 1 AP for the Lurk Artist, but the Eagles theme team, man, we just don't have anybody else to put in the box, man. Like I said, I got Carmichael playing in the box with him with the 0 AP Lurk Artist. Now, this defense, Dawkins is actually not even playing. He's kind of just here for depth. He doesn't play in this defense. I'll kind of go and practice and explain how I'm running this and kind of show you it a little bit, but he's actually not playing, which, I mean, It's a good thing because he doesn't really get any discounts anyway that are really that good. And it's a bad thing because, I mean, we all love Dawkins, man. But hey, man. Now, I mean, technically, I could put him in because how the defense works is you got 2 outside corners. You got 5 defensive linemen. And then you got 2 guys playing in the box. And you have, like, a slot corner. But that slot corner, you can put a safety there or a slot corner. So you're really putting your best DB there. So I have Rasul Douglas there just because, I mean, he's, you know, faster and he's just gonna play a lot better than Dawkins. But yeah, Dawkins is basically not playing right now. We still got Asante on the outside with that deep out zone KO. I'm not gonna lie, I want to get Pick Artist on him, but I'm gonna have, it's 2 AP, so I'd have to find a way to free up some AP. I don't know how we're gonna do that. We got Jalen Carter playing in the middle with the inside stuff. So like I said, 5 D linemen, so you got the inside stuff in the middle, the 2 No Outsiders on the outside. The ball is not being ran. That's just not happening. We got Big Play Slay with the deep out zone and Pick Artist. So really the only people that don't have any catching abilities on the defense is Rasul Douglas and Asante Samuel. But I think I'm gonna get Steven Nelson probably because he gets that zero AP pick order, so that's a major. And then if I could just find a way to somehow get two AP freed up, which I can't. I'm just hoping we get more cards, then eventually Sante would get pick artist, or they could just give us a new corner. So this is basically kind of what this 3-4 defense looks like. You're going to have Kevin Byer deep with the pick artist in the deep end. You got Asante and Slay here on the outside. They got Carmichael. You got Channing Crowder in the box. And then obviously the focal point, like I said, the D-line. So you got Javon Curse on this outside. He's going to go crazy. You got Hassan Reddick off the other edge. He's about to go crazy. And the inside, you got Minister here with this X-Factor. And like I said, I was using this last night. This man, he's 1-on-1. It's a sack. So put it like that. Then you got big old Jalen Carter in the middle with the inside stuff. You're not running the ball in the middle. The only weak point is kind of Nolan Smith, man, because Nolan Smith is more of a guy. He's supposed to be off the edge. Now, I haven't used him in the inside because how I ran it last night, I had him off the edge. But now that I got another 1 AP no outsider, I guess we're going to kind of see how this works. I don't know. We'll see. Don't worry. I'm not going to have Javon Curse dropping a little curl flat, man. The way I'm running this 3-4 bear, he ain't dropping a little curl flat. He's going to be getting to the quarterback. So I'm excited to see what he does in this tonight, man. And like I said, I'm having fun running this 3-4 bear. Last night was my first night running it. I played house rules. I think I won about 12-2, won 3 Super Bowls in it. So I'm going to play some more of it tonight, and I guess we'll just see what happens. Let me know if you guys picked up the brand new Javon Curse, how you guys liking him, what abilities you're rocking on him. A lot of you guys probably didn't because, like I said, his price is just not worth it. $800,000 for a guy that doesn't get anything for zero AP is actually wild, but the Ultimate Legends promo, man, has become a little bit of a joke, to be honest. And the reason why I haven't really been dropping any gameplays is because, like I said, I've been playing house rules, and I've definitely had some crazy games happen in house rules, but like it's just the games are so short. I don't know if you guys really want to see it. If you guys want to see some house rules gameplay, let me know down in the comments. I can do it, but that's why I haven't dropped any, gameplays and stuff. That's kind of all I've been playing. But if you want to see me play it live tonight, link in the description down to the Twitch. Go ahead and click that, and we will be on that. Trying to recoup some coins. I think the goal tonight is maybe get Steven to either get Steven Nelson tonight or get finish maxing out Byer. So let me know which one I should do first.